if you guys knew how bad my handwriting was, this would be 10 times more impressive, so. It all begins with a single swipe, something you've done 1,000 times, all for the low price of $2.75. It all begins with a single swipe. You walk down some poorly lit corridor, look around, you've been here before, the subway. No, not the sandwich shop, though that has the same amount of grease. No, not the play, though that has too many things you can describe as sandy. No, not cheeks, though we both know we've seen far too many on the subway. Speaking of which, let's get back on the track, back to the tracks. Tracks so familiar they belong on all your Spotify daily mixes. But for some reason today, they're different. Because for the first time, these subway lines, they read like poetry. Mundanity and drabness as if you're stuck in someone else's soliloquy, but at least you're not alone. You atone for your sins wading through this modern day River Styx, wondering what the hell did I do to deserve this? It reeks of sewage and of regret, the New Yorker scent, extracted from false promises and broken dreams. It seems the greatest city on earth hides things in its vast underbelly. Platforms and tracks as dirty as the souls of those above it, and if we're being honest with ourselves, they're not getting any cleaner. But something is getting nearer and nearer. Of course it's a train. You're in the subway. As you endeavor to flee using daydreams, you're still stuck waiting on the 3 or the 4 or the D. But something knocks you out of sorts, not one of nature's shows of force, and you stand clear of it, closing doors. But once you're in a train, like an wonderful refrain, it's familiar, but not mundane, because after walking through mounds of crowds and seeing blurs and flashing words, you finally see people's faces. As you sit or stand in a broken strand of the veins of New York City, you realize that even in an electrical metal car, moving at 50, you're still surrounded by humanity. A family speaking in a language you don't know how to hear, but you just know their words of love. A single dad, after a hard day at work, clutching his sleeping daughter in his arms and believing that's his reward. It's a paradise yearning for butterflies and better times that remind you that dreams can still exist, even in this mechanical city. Because the subway is the greatest man-made equalizer, because there's no businessmen or beggars or even language barriers, because in here, all we have is each other. It's hard to feel like you matter in the greatest city on earth, but when you're under it, it isn't even a question.